The meeting of the Board of Appeals will now come to order. Roll call.
Mr. Pacilli? Mr. Corrin is absent. Mr. D'Angelo is absent. Mr. Mazzoni? Mr. Colometto is absent. Mr. Tucker?
Present.
First matter before... He can't participate remotely, no. The first matter before the board is application A1703. This is the application of Margarita and Lionel Martinez, 65 Union Street, Revere, requesting the following variances. Minimum lot area, minimum rear yard, to enable the appellants to petition the planning board to subdivide lots 13, 14, 57, 58, and 59 Union Street and June Street to create new lots, a new lot containing 8,369.2 square feet, and lot 25, 26, 27, and 28 Union Street and June Street to create new lot B with the structure thereon as 65 Union Street, Revere.
Okay, if the clerk would just explain to the viewing public that we will be conducting this meeting, however, we cannot vote on anything due to not having a quorum.
The relevant statute is the open meeting law, which allows participation remotely. One of our members was prepared to participate this evening remotely. However, the open meeting law requires that a quorum be present in the chamber before remote participation can take place. A quorum of the Zoning Board of Appeals is four members, of which only three are in the chamber this evening. Additionally, the statutes also provide for members who are not present at the time of the meeting to subsequently review the records of the hearing, and at a subsequent date, they would be eligible to vote on the matter. So we are going to request the absent members this evening to review the public hearing records that is created this evening, and they would be in a position to vote on the matter at the next meeting of the Zoning Board of Appeals.
Good evening. If you could just state your name and address for the record.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, members of the board, Joseph Cotogio, 1 Sprague Street, Revere, representing the applicant, seeking to realign the lots as indicated by the clerk. My client is the owner of 65 Union Street, a pre-existing house or presently existing house that is accompanied by a number of lots that are presently configured in an odd shape, whereas the main house has a lot on an L-shaped lot, and there are additional lots to the rear. This is at the end of Union Street. It borders on the backside to Temple Street and to the street that connects the two on Union Street. So it is a U-shaped area that is owned by my client. The normal configuration of house lots as they come down Temple and Union Street is for the lot line or the division line to be right down the middle between Temple and Union. This is exactly what we are proposing to do to have a better configuration on the lots. We presented this to site plan review, who approved the idea of the reconfiguration but had to deny the application because of the pre-existing house, which has been in existence for a large number of years and at present has a grandfathered front yard and rear yard, which obviously with the new lot configuration would no longer be grandfathered. So the variances we are seeking are on a house that already exists. There is no proposed construction for that house. In other words, we are not doing anything to create those variances other than reassign the lot. So there's no construction proposed. The new lot configuration will create a standard, actually an excess standard buildable lot on Temple Street, which will have more than 8,000 square feet, 100 foot or in excess of 100 feet of frontage, and will comply with all of the zoning regulations. I did speak to the ward counselor. I spoke to Counselor Guanasso. I went over this in detail with him. He did advise that he had no problem with it. He was not aware of any calls in opposition. I have not received any calls in opposition. I'm not aware of any as well. We're here to answer any questions you might have, and understanding the situation with the members, if we could keep this open to the next meeting, I have no problem with attending that and presenting other additional information that they might need or that you might need.
Okay, seeing this is a public hearing, are there any proponents, anyone in favor? Hearing none, I'll close that side of the hearing. Any opponents, anyone opposed? Hearing none, I'll close that side of the hearing. Any members wish to speak? I do have two questions myself. The shed, will that be removed?
Yes.
And parking for the lot with the house on it, where is the parking?
I believe that the pictures show there's parking off-street on the right. There can also be that whole side yard, which would now be used as a yard, can also accompany two spaces as well.
And that's for the existing house?
That's for the existing house. The lot in the back, anybody who were to build on that would have to comply with all of the zoning regulations, Board of Health regulations, and construction, and provide suitable off-street parking for that, any new construction. With regard to the shed, it would either be removed or moved so that it would not encroach on any lot line.
Okay. Seeing that this plan does not meet the Board of Appeals regulations, that if you read our packet when you submit anything, it has to have all of the current zoning and dimensional controls on the plan, and you'd have to depict the parking. So by the next meeting, could you please make sure that is complete?
Yep, I can do that.
And I advise anyone coming in front of the Board of Appeals that will be something that we'll be looking at. You have to read the instructions when you're submitting the plans, because we want everything on the plan that's requested. So no members wish to speak, so we can go on to the next calendar item number. What do you want? So is there a motion to continue till April 26th? And seconded? All in favor? Continue to April 26th.
The next application before the board is application A1704. This is a special permit application of Christine McCarron, 450 Revere Beach Blvd rear, requesting a special permit to enable the appellant to further alter and extend a preexisting nonconforming structure to convert a single-family dwelling to a two-family dwelling on Lot Part C at 450 Revere Beach Blvd rear.
Good afternoon. Name and address for the record, please. And could you just press the button once? It will turn. There you go.
Christine McCarron, 450 Revere Beach Blvd.
Do you have anything else to say?
I would like to answer any questions, and just, do you want me to summarize the plan?
We had a chance to read the application packet, so I'll go on with the public hearing, and I'll ask if there's any proponents. Hearing none, I'll close that side of the hearing. Are you a proponent in favor?
No, I'm not.
Okay. If you're in favor, it's proponent. You can step up to the microphone and if you wish to speak. Well, we need your name and address for the record if you're a proponent.
My name is Veronica Lujan, and my address is 47 Carlton Street.
In Revere?
Revere.
47 Carlton?
Yes.
Okay, and the name?
Veronica Lujan.
Could you spell that for him, please?
V-E-R-O-N-I-C-A. L-U-J-A-N.
Okay, thank you. Are there any opponents? Up in here, the ward councilor wishes to speak.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. I had occasion to speak to the building inspector this week and also to the city engineer, and also view some of the existing foundation where the present building is located. It's a cinder block foundation. I don't believe there is any footing. I think to grant this without an engineering study would be not only a disservice to the city of Revere, but also to the person looking to grant relief here. Right now, there's two buildings that are joined together on that property. It's a cinder block foundation, as I said. It's I don't believe there's any footing, according to the city engineer. They're looking to go 52 and a half feet, I believe. And well, the zoning is in place for that. This is zoned RC1 or RC2, I believe, which would be 12 or 14 stories. That's not the problem. The problem is the foundation itself. And I've spoken with the building inspector, and he is not ready to issue any building permit for this property until he has a engineering study from a certified engineer that will sign on this. So again, I would ask that this be, well, it's going to be continued anyway because you don't have a quorum, but I would ask that nothing be done on this anyway until they come back with that engineering study, and that indicates they either they can or they cannot do it. The other thing, too, is the city has an easement several feet from that property. And that's the main drain line that comes from Carey Circle all the way down to the boulevard. And I think to, again, allow this without the proper foundation in there could cause a problem for the city and probably 1,500 residents down the boulevard and down the Point of Pines. So, again, I'd ask that this be just tabled as it is going to be, and we'll go from there at the next meeting. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Any other opponents?
Good evening. My name is Lawrence Michelson, and I built a house at 454 Revere Beach Boulevard, and I complied with all of the rules and the regulations of the conservation and the city of Revere. I have put together for each one of you, which I can present if you would allow me to do that.
You can hand it to the clerk.
Okay. How many would you like? I have several.
There are five members, so.
Five members, okay.
And six with the clerk.
I'll give you six of them. So let's see. Let me count here. One, two, three,
your address was 454, you stated?
454, yes.
Revere Beach Boulevard.
There are six documents which I put together. Thank you. I also have some pictures that I'd like to leave with you. The pictures are of 450 Rear, Revere Beach Boulevard, the proposed construction of a two-family, which I'm against. I have the pictures of their property. I also have the picture of my property, which I went to great expense to put up. And my fear is They are in a flood zone. My fear is that if they put up what they want, that I will have a problem with flooding. As of now, I do not have any problem. But that house has a flooding problem. They have a pump which continuously pumps water from that property into their backyard. And I'm just afraid that what will happen is that I will have a flood issue with my property. There is also a problem with a right-of-way that houses three of us. It is a driveway to enter and exit. And basically, they have no place to park. There are no guest parking areas for them. They don't have access to the back lot. They have to go through my lot to get to the back lot, and that's not going to happen. So I feel that the board should reject their application to put a two-family house there. The papers that I gave you is self-explaining, and I hope that the board will review it and take everything under consideration, but that's not the proper thing to do at that location. I have no objections if he wants to rehab the house and he wants to make it livable and presentable. I have no objections to that, but I do have objections to a four-family. Thank you very much for hearing me. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Would you like these pictures?
Yes, please.
Are
there any other opponents?
My name is Valentina Patterson, 452 on Revere Beach. It is a right front from that proposed.
At 452?
452. So I do have a water problem already whenever it's raining and something obstructing that water to go back to the river. And if they will build a huge house and push that ground back down, we will have water in my basement. That's not going to work. And on the top of that, the driveway. They have to use our driveway to get to their property right now. And the, you know, two cars, it's the max what can be there.
Okay. Thank you.
Just one last thing, may I say. Property that I built. Would you like me to do that? Or is that self-explanatory? That's the one, yes.
Yeah.
That's 454.
Yes, we have that on the plan.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Are there any other opponents? Hearing none, I'll close that side of the hearing. To the applicant, if you could step up to the microphone, please. Hearing the concerns of the ward councilor and of the building department. This is being continued anyways because we don't have a quorum to vote on it, but I would ask that you have a structural engineer provide the proper information to our engineering department as well as our building department prior to the next meeting, because mm-hmm. We'll be looking for their opinion right. Before we take any vote.
Right. I had already, I know that the structure, the basement is not going to be currently strong enough to support anything basically larger than what's there right now. And I had planned to actually dig up that foundation and put down a new one, and I was told that that won't be an option. So I found that out on Monday, and I've already spoken to a couple of engineers who are going to come out and do a survey, and the proposals so far have been helical piles or injection grouting or just some type of underpinning of the existing foundation.
Now, I'm not involved in it, but would you have to go in front of the Conservation Commission on building on this?
I have to regardless, yeah. So, no matter what, I have to go in front of the Conservation okay. Commission once we finish here.
But it may be null and void for us because they're going to require you to have the flood zone type of foundation with
exactly.
them. So if you can't do that, then...
No, I definitely can. This is all stuff that would happen underneath. They told me that I can't come before the Conservation Commission until I have your approval. So it kind of in a... If you think I can go there first...
No, you can't go
okay.
there first. But if you're going to be taking up the foundation and...
No,
and changing the footprint, well, you would have to take it up because in order to do the new foundation for the Conservation Commission, it's, you couldn't have an existing foundation there, because it has to be dug down and pilings and...
So this is what I was told on Monday, because that was my original plan, is to take off the existing foundation and put it in correctly so that it's going to be, you know, water can pass through it and all that. But I was told on Monday that I can't touch the existing foundation, because then it'll be like a new construction and I'll have to...
Yeah,
they said, so I don't know. I mean, if I can...
I think you have to meet with the building department as well as the city engineer and before you come back to us, because we're going to ask for their opinion. And
right.
That's the, basically what one of our things that we'll have to base our votes on is their opinions as well.
Well, what it was the city engineer who told me that if I touch the existing foundation, then it basically becomes like a new construction and I can't keep the house. Do you know what I mean? So I don't know what to do about that.
You should consult with the building department as well.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. And I don't know. Should I address the parking situation? I mean, there is not... The current proposal is for parking to just be underneath the house, so it won't cause any problems for anyone else. We're not talking about, you know, driving down anybody else's land to get to the parking or anything like that. It's just all going to be underneath the structure.
That's kind of hard to see on your plan. So you're going to have four parking spaces with two under and two in front, or how is it going to be?
There'll be three under, and then essentially, you know, people could park in what is now the front yard as well. But we just won't need anywhere near that much parking. So right now, if you were looking at the proposed structure, the left side will have one parking space, and the right side will have a two-car garage. So both of those would be underneath the foundation or within the walls of the foundation, because we need to elevate the house anyway to get it out of the base flood elevation. So that will allow room for parking underneath. And then there will also be, because the existing front yard is also deep enough to put, you know, another car. So you could basically park behind the garage doors on both sides. And Larry mentioned the pump that goes all the time. The existing garage basically is below grade. So the water runs from everywhere into the garage. So that's why we're constantly pumping water. But once we raise the floor of that garage above, you know, basically above the grade, then there's not going to be any, I don't anticipate any pumping at all.
You have to go with the building department, and you can consult with the Conservation Commission as we speak, because you can't have any type of asphalt or anything
right.
in there. So your car would be literally driven on crushed stone.
Yeah, that's fine. It's better than what we have now. I mean, basically, right, like I said, right now, it's like an underneath garage, so the driveway and everything, the water just runs right in there and sits in a puddle in there. If there's any kind of groundwater or any kind of rain, it fills right up. I mean, it's a terrible design. So that, you know, I just want to make that the same level as the street, as the ground, so that we don't get that problem and it would just be crushed stone or whatever.
So basically what's going to happen is we continue this till April 26th, and by that time you should have presented a structural engineer drawing to both the building department and the city engineer and satisfy their questions before it would come back to us.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The next application before the board is application A1705. This is the application of Batten Brothers Signs and Awnings, 893 Main Street, Wakefield, requesting a variance to enable the appellant to install a third exterior sign on lot 6A at 339 Squire Road, Revere.
Mr. Chairman.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, members of the board. My name is Richard Batten. I'm representing Batten Brothers and Eastern Bank. And what we're requesting is Eastern Bank took over the Metro PCS building in the Northgate Shopping Center, which is a freestanding building in the middle of the parking lot. What we're requesting is a third sign on the building. It's a wall sign. It's 21 and a quarter square feet. So it's 20 inches by a little over 12 feet long, and it's made up of individual letters. It's the side of the building that's actually facing towards the most of the shopping center. In other words, it's facing actually away from the street. The only place you would see this is actually in the shopping center. And the reason they're requesting a third sign is that one sign is on the front of the building facing Squire Road. Second sign is, again, on the building facing towards the main access to the shopping center. And then the third one is actually facing where most of the people do the parking. So all three signs are identical. They're all the same size, 21 square feet, comprised of white individual letters that light up in, internally. And that's about it.
Okay, thank you. Seeing that the public hearing, are there any proponents? Anyone in favor? Just for the record, I did speak to the ward councilor. He is not, he didn't have any opposition to this. Now I will ask if there is any opponents. Anyone opposed? Hearing none, I'll close that side of the hearing. Any members wish to speak? Okay, this will be continued till April 26th for a vote.
The next application before the board is application A1706. This is the application of Hazania Residential LLC, 83 Bennington Street, Revere, requesting the following variances: front yard, side yard, rear yard, setbacks, FAR, screening for parking, minimum parking, minimum screening for non-residential use to enable the appellant to construct a five-story, 22 residential unit, transit-oriented apartment structure on lots 224 and 225 at 83 Bennington Street, Revere.
Good afternoon, board members. My name is Corey Rhodes, and I'm an attorney with D'Ambrosio Brown, LLP, 14 Proctor Avenue in Revere. I represent Mr. Hassania, who is attempting to come before you and seek your approval to build this new modern transit-oriented development with 22 units and 20 parking spaces at 83 Bennington Street. He's working with Anthony Delvecchio of Delvecchio Construction to try to make this happen. What we're bringing in for you today is a project that has gone through a couple of different revisions. We've been meeting with the mayor's office, with inspectional services, and the ward counselor to try to find the best project that's going to fit for this location. Originally being proposed was a much larger structure. It was planned to be 35 units with still around 20 parking spaces, but after going back and forth and working with the ward counselor, she said she would like to see a much smaller project there, and that's why we brought forward this 22-unit proposal. And this is these are substantially one-bedroom units, around 650 square feet, so small units. And as we mentioned, this is going to be transit-oriented because the Beachmont Station is right down the street, approximately 350 yards. You know, just takes a couple of minutes to walk there. And the property itself is only going to be marketed towards people that are really commuters, not needing cars, and looking just to be young professionals who would hop on the train and go into the city or something like that. There's also going to be bike storage at the property, another way that we're trying to cut down on the need for a lot of vehicles. The particular proposal, getting this building to fit on this lot, you know, it was, again, a lot of different considerations went into it. The zoning ordinance, for instance, requires you to have a 15-foot setback on either side of the property. But when we met with the fire department, they said, you know what, we would really rather there be one side that has 20 feet so that we can get a fire truck down that way if there's any kind of incident that we need to get into the back of the building in an emergency. So we've proposed to just shift the building slightly to the left. That's why one side's going to be a 10-foot setback on the left side of the building and a 20-foot setback on the right so that, if necessary, a fire truck could come down that way. And that's why, you know, this is really more of a tailored project than, you know, we could fit within the ordinance. We could do 15 feet on both sides, but that's not really what was best suited here. Beyond that, we just think it's going to be a big improvement for this property. It was a long-time automotive repair garage. much better views to fit with the neighboring residential buildings that are of a similar height and density. And we'd be happy to answer any questions you have and ask for your approval. Thank you.
Thank you. Seeing that it's a public hearing, are there any proponents? Anyone in favor? Hearing none, I'll close that side of the hearing. Any opponents? Anyone opposed?
Hi.
Good afternoon.
My name is Geraldine Panacchio, and I'm from 77 Bennington Street, apartment 207, and I'm one of the trustees there. We're opposing the structure because if he's going to build 22 units with 20 parking spots, they're going to have, no visitor spots in on the premise. That'll mean all the other spots on the street are going to be taken over. Plus, the structure is going to be too much when they're going to build it on our side. When they took down the garage, my building, not mine, all of ours, was shaken like we were in a grinder. We cannot afford to get a structural engineer in there. So I'm definitely opposed to this. And if we can, if I need to get signatures from all the residents in my building and on the street, I certainly will, whatever it needs to be. The project is a little too big for 22 units to go up five floors, and also not enough parking spots. And there's no guarantee you have a one bedroom, it's gonna be a one person. Could be a couple, they could have two cars. Where are these people gonna park? Okay. I mean, I appreciate because listening to me, because I did go to City Hall the other day and got what I needed to get, but it's not even legible, the structure itself. If you look at the third page from the back, first it says 30 units residential at 83 and 85 Bennington, but then it doesn't really have too much here.
What are you referring to?
The third page from the back. You have anything different? How could there be a typo? You can't even read it. I mean, come on.
If I could describe to you, this is the parking plan showing the parking layout of the building, and it is 77 to the right of this building. So this is actually further than the ordinance would have us put it. It's actually 20 feet away. The building won't start until this side.
That's not even the problem.
Okay.
The problem is you don't have enough parking.
It is the a very street, high ratio.
The street is very congested. We got commuters coming in there, and they're all in front of that property. Mm-hmm. So when your property is going to be constructed, they're going to be in front of ours. We do have three visitor spots where I am, but they're always occupied because it's 34 units.
Okay.
So, I mean, something's got to be done here.
Well, I'd be happy to talk to you more about it after this. Will be continued.
Okay. This will be continued because it won't be voted on this evening, April 26th.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
And is there any other opponents? If you'd please step up to the mic, state your name and address for the record.
Mr. Chairman, Board. My name is Paula Modica, and I am the property manager for 77 Bennington Street. And I represent all of the owners, which there were 34. Our biggest concern, again, is the parking. I think that it is, it was ill-stated that they will not need more than 20 parking spaces. As times change, especially in property management, you see more and more people who have not only one car, but two cars. And so 20 parking spaces just never do. The street is only one side you can park on. And at times, especially in the winter, there is a snow ban, and then there is no parking on the street. The other concern, as the unit owner stated, is the construction. The last time when they demolished the building, not only did the building shake, but we did have cracks in the building.
Okay, not to cut you short, but we're here to walk, look at dimensions and anything else. All of that could have been addressed with the city department, you know, with the building department when that happened.
Okay, so it is the parking that we are very concerned about. 20 units is just too many units and not enough parking.
Now, your building is 34 units?
Yes.
You stay, how many parking spaces for that building?
We have about 30, 30, yeah, 37, 38.
38 parking spaces?
Yes.
And the
it's not enough. It is not enough.
And these are condos?
They are condos, condominiums.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Are there any other opponents?
My name is Ronald Santos-Wasso. Live at 77 Bennington Street. And the size of your lot is 100 by 100. You don't specify one bedroom, two bedroom, which means a lot of square footage. So the front, if he's willing to give up 20 feet for the fire department and 15 feet on the other side, you got a frontage of only 65 feet left. So I don't know how many units are going to fit in that size area. The two-bedroom would be like 30 feet. So there would only be two in the front.
Okay, the applicant...
I have to wait for him to...
Yeah, the applicant would gladly meet with you and discuss all of that. But your opposition right now is for parking?
It's for parking. It's for, it's in a flood area. It's going to affect the overflow.
That's conservation, nothing to do with us, but anything else?
Yeah, the parking is the main thing. And I just can't see how you can fit it in the, like putting a big thing in a small box.
Okay.
That's it.
Well taken. Are there any other opponents? Hearing none, I'll close that side of the hearing. I would suggest that you possibly meet with the applicant so he can answer some of the questions that you may have had concerning the number of units, the sizes of units. He'd be more than happy to meet with you and discuss that. We will vote on this on April 26th, our next meeting.
The next application before the board is application A-1707. This is the application of Veronica Lojan, 77 Stowers Street, Revere, requesting a variance to enable the appellant to raise the existing garage structure on lot 67 to qualify lot 67 as a buildable lot for a single-family dwelling adjacent to 67 Carlton Street, Revere.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, board members. My name is Corey Rhodes. I'm an attorney with D'Ambrosio Brown, LLP, 14 Proctor Avenue in Revere. I represent the owner of this property, Veronica Lujan, and it is a fairly simple request that we have one of these dual lot properties, and under the ordinance, if you have a dual lot and you meet all your parking requirements on the existing house, you can proceed to build a house on the vacant lot. Unfortunately, our lot does have a small structure on it, so we're in front of you tonight seeking a variance for that qualified lot requirement. But just to alleviate any concerns you might have, only proposal here is to build a single-family house, meets all dimensional requirements otherwise, has all parking requirements. It is a very straightforward house that they're looking to put in. I think it'll improve the neighborhood and raise property values, just kind of all those traditional things. If you have any questions, I'd be happy to answer them. And just as another note, my clients have been active with their neighbors, talking to them about this project, and they were able to get 17 signatures from some of the neighbors in the area, all in support of this petition.
If you'd like to present that to the clerk, we do have time to check them out because we'll be voting on this on April 26th. Seeing that this is a public hearing, are there any proponents? Anyone in favor? Kindly step up to the microphone, state your name and address for the record.
Hi, how are you? My name's Jenny Mesa.
Okay, you have to, Jenny Vizzo?
G-E-N-I-S-M-E-S-A. I live in 77 Star Wars Street.
Okay.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Betzaida Vicente, B-E-T-Z-A-I-D-A. Last name is V-I-C-E-N-T-E, and I live at 19 Prince Street.
Okay, thank you.
Good evening. My name is Edwin Montoya, and I also live on the same street, and I'm in favor.
Okay, could you spell your, the spelling of your name so he can put it for the record?
Edwin, E-D-W-I-N, Montoya, M-O-N-T-O-Y-A.
And what number are you at?
28 Carlington Street. I also signed the paperwork.
Carlton?
Yeah, same street.
Okay.
Thank you.
Anyone else as a proponent? Hearing none, I'll close that side of the hearing. Any opponents? Please step up to the microphone, state your name and address for the record.
Hello. Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman and members of the board. My name is Colleen Reyes. I live at 53 Carlton Street. I'm right next door to the proposed construction. So I've been a resident for 10 years now. It'll be 10 years in March. I'm a local business owner. I'm a teacher at the Romney Marsh Academy. And my kids go to school in Revere. So I have very invested interest in the city. I have huge concerns over adding another property on my street. I'm right on the corner. And right now, there is very limited parking. I know parking's been the hot button issue today. I'm going to add to that. I know that it's a city concern. I know this administration has been addressing it, and I truly appreciate that. But in the meantime, this property is going to tap into the limited parking that already exists. Our small street has parking on one side, which I know is typical. But it's one block. So we have many homes on the street that have multiple people living in it with cars. They have, some of them have off-street parking, but that off-street parking might be single lane. So they choose to park a car on the street, which obviously is their, if it's up to them to do that, but that closes off parking for other residents that might need to use it, as myself. I work day and night, so when I come home late at night and I can't park anywhere near my home, obviously it's frustrating. And the same with my husband. I've requested, which I know is a completely separate issue, to improve my situation, and I've been denied. So I find it frustrating to, I asked for a driveway and was denied, which is a, I know, a totally separate issue, and it's not to meant to sway any decisions, but I adding another home and creating more of a problem for me obviously is an issue. I want to stay here. I want my kids to grow up here, and I love it here, but I feel like another property right next to mine is not going to improve my quality of life. The home that is there right now on that double lot has been vacant for a long time. I know they've been improving it and renovating it, but right now nobody is living there, and I expect that it's going to be rented. As we know, homeowners have more of an investment in a property than a renter. I'm very aware of that. And the single-family home, I understand it's a single-family home, but again, who's going to be living there? Is it going to be sold to a homeowner? I don't know. Or is it going to be rented? Basically, when they did come around and spoke to us, I was actually introduced as new. I'm going to be we're your new neighbors. So I was very friendly and open to conversation, and then it became, oh, but we're going to add another house, and if we don't add a house, then they're going to, people want to park trucks in the lot. And it was just a very, I felt like I was very much misled, and I didn't appreciate that either. Obviously, I'm sure they will not feel that they misled me, but I felt misled after the conversation. I was trying to be open to who I thought was going to be living right next door to me, and then it was a whole different ball of wax. So I'm here before you just asking that the board consider my points, and that's it. I appreciate your time. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Are there any other opponents? Hearing none, I'll close that side of the hearing. Opponent? How are you? Please state your name and address for the record.
My name is Frank Tenera, 36 Folsom Street. I've been living there forever, my whole life. And if you know Collin Street well, these double lots, this is the third one. Well, there's been three that have been done on Collin Street. This is another one. There's the fourth one they want to do. And there's another one coming down the pike that's going to be coming up pretty soon. The street's just too crowded. It just, drive down Collin Street. All that parking, all these two families, they're all coming on Folsom Street. The parking's a mess, and I know it's the big issue. But you know, I'm not against anyone doing work, you know, like you said, if it meets all the laws. I got the letter, to tell you the truth, I don't even know what's being proposed. I'd like to, you know, I'll speak to him after to see what is being proposed. The house that is existing does not have a lot. They're giving up their lot to build this house. So I don't know where that existing house is going to park either. Like I said, this is the, you know, fourth double lot on the street, and it's just still plain and simple, it's overcrowded. And at some point, you know, it's making the neighborhood difficult. And like, you know, the woman before me said, you come home and you can't park anywhere, so. Okay. So I'll meet with him, and I just want to see what is proposed, so.
Thank you. Are there any other opponents? Good afternoon. Name and address for the record.
Lenny Orlandello, 22 Folsom Street. I don't live on Carlton Street, but I live on Folsom Street. The property being proposed is about 50 yards from my house. You just cross the street, and there's one house, and then there's the lot. My concern is the same concern the whole city has. It's parking. We have zero parking there now, and if that house is built, not only is that going to add cars to the street, but the existing house parks where that lot is now. So that existing two-family is going to add 4 to 5 cars. They're going to lose their yard, their driveway, and they're going to add a home that's going to add another 2 or 3 cars. So you're talking about putting 6 or 7 more cars where there's not room for even one car now. Like Colleen said, when you go out and you come back, that spot's gone. You can't leave your house for 5 minutes, 10 minutes. It's just the parking is ridiculous. And that's my main concern. And I'm definitely opposed to this project. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other opponents? Okay, hearing none, I'll close that side of the hearing. There are some questions that I'd like just to clarify for the audience here. Your proposed building, the structure behind it is being raised, right? So
correct.
That's being removed.
Correct.
So the one proposed new single-family home, mm-hmm. you depict 4 parking spaces on the property.
This was actually my fault in not raising this. There actually will be one garage space underneath the building, and you could actually have a car park in that garage. This was something that my clients brought to me, and I said, well, you're actually providing more parking than the ordinance requires, but they said that's what they wanted. So this will be a single-family house that has one garage space and does have your traditional driveway with those two spaces on the right. And just to clarify, the existing house on 47 Carlton is just a single family house. It does have an existing driveway on the right, so it does meet its parking requirements as well. I hope there wasn't some miscommunication regarding some two families or something. That is not the case. We have one single family house that's existing, and they want to build another single family house. Not multiple units, multiple residences, and the amount of parking that they're providing really should not mean that any cars related to these properties are parking on the street.
Okay, thank you. But just for my clarification, yeah. You're only required to have the two spaces,
correct.
But correct. On this plan it shows 4, so that is what you will have, and
that's,
if you were to get the approval for a new home, you'd have 4 spaces there.
4,000 square feet.
Is that on the side?
No. That's this, for this district and this overlay, it's 4,000 square foot lot.
Okay. This will be heard again on April 26th when we hopefully will have a quorum at that time to take a vote on it.
The next application before the board is application A1708. This is the application of DCM Realty LLC, 25 Renee Drive, Wakefield, requesting the following variances: minimum lot area, minimum frontage, minimum front yard setback, side yard setback, rear yard setback, maximum FAR, minimum parking, minimum screening to enable the appellant to reconstruct a nonconforming structure at 7-9 DeHone Street to construct a three-story mixed-use building comprising four residential units and two commercial units at 7-9 DeHone Street, Revere.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, board members. My name is Corey Rhodes, and I'm an attorney with D'Ambrosio Brown, LLP, 14 Proctor Avenue, Revere. I represent the applicant, DCM Realty, LLC, related to this new structure for 7-9 DeHone Street. This is a highly irregular lot, triangular, really, if you see it on the plans, and has held a very blighted structure for quite some time, probably one of the worst, really, in the city. And of recently, my client was able to acquire this property and has put together this proposal to build a new transit-oriented six-unit development that is two commercial units on the ground floor to try to activate some of the streetscape and some of the sidewalks so people coming from the T or going past might be able to stop in, get a coffee, you know, have some local businesses in there. And then above this, there will be two floors that would each have two residential units, so a total of four residential units. This has been something he's been working on for quite a while. In talking with the ward counselor, things that he really wanted to see were that these would be micro units, single bedrooms, you know, no two bedrooms, you know, that people weren't going to be bringing families. These are really just going to be for young professionals who are going to jump on the T and head into the city or something like that. So that's exactly what we have here, that these are all single bedroom units, about 650 square feet, and the Revere Beach T station is only about 300 feet away. So really, again, a transit-oriented property. Beyond that, you know, these lower-level commercial spaces is something that the mayor's office really wanted to see to really try to activate that square. There's some other businesses in that area, and by taking out this blighted property and putting in this new building, we're really hoping to, you know, continue a trend for this square on DeHone and Centennial to really make a vibrant area in the community. Beyond that, if you have any additional questions or concerns, we're happy to go over them. We think it's a really good project.
Okay. If you could just define what a micro unit is, because people are concerned that that's like a rooming house, there's no kitchen.
No.
This is basically just a one-bedroom unit.
Correct.
In a 650-square-foot footprint.
Yeah. It basically means just a small apartment so that you're not going to have a lot of, you know, people living in them. Basically, these are going to be one-room occupancy, one person coming in and living there, but these are, you know, rental apartments. They're going to be nice places. You know, they're looking for young professionals to live in them and you know, be able to just take a quick T ride to get into the city.
Okay. Thank you. Seeing that it's a public hearing, any proponents? Ward Councilor, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman, members of the commission. My name is Ira Novoselsky. I live at 53 DeHone Street in Revere, and I am the Ward 2 Councilor. This area involved is GB District, general business, and we've been developing this neighborhood. We have an idea for the neighborhood. This is part of it. The facility that's there now, as you've seen, has been totally uncalled for, and we're glad it's going to be ripped down. We have to make adjustments to make it happen, and with the new TOD scenario, this is a perfect project for the TOD. We gave one to 17 DeHone Street several months ago, and it's a beautiful building going up. It's a similar type design. It's not a square building. There'll be a little offsets to it, as you can see. And as I stated before, we've already offset the parking with the Traffic Commission to eliminate all the meters on that triangle and put in permit parking for residents. So that'll eliminate the people going into Boston and parking there 2, 3, 4 hours at a time. So there are 16 spaces on that triangle. Before, there were 9 meters. So we're eliminating the meters and making them parking for the residents. And also, I've had an agreement from the applicant to put in bike racks on the island itself, because there's a big section of the island on the east side that they'll be putting bike racks in to help anybody that wants to put a bike rack there, whether it be the residents or other neighbors that want to use it. Of course, mostly summertime. If they want to use it wintertime, that's up to them. But I am in favor of this, and I look forward to energizing the neighborhood down in the Shirley Ave area. So thank you for your time.
Thank you. Are there any other proponents? Anyone in favor? Hearing none, I'll close that side of the hearing. Any opponents? Anyone opposed? Hearing none, I'll close that side of the hearing. So this, again, will be heard on April 26th. And at that time, we hope to have a quorum so we can take a vote. No further business. Thank you, and have a good afternoon.